This morning on Leonard's Look, our Mike Leonard has a story appropriate for this season of giving. It is about music and heartfelt generosity bringing people together.
They were strangers once. The Chicago widow and the Irish musician, brought together by the movie Once.
Falling slowly.
It was just about good people who ended up doing the right thing.
It was verification that generosity exists.
And living proof of how a meeting between strangers in the movies and in our everyday existence can turn into an incredible gift, but only if something is given in return.
I absolutely agree. I'm a real believer in when something comes into your life, the best way to hang on to it is to pass it on.
10 cents.
Glen Hansard, with his guitar full of holes, was originally hired to write the music for Once. But when the male lead dropped out of the production, Glen found himself in front of the camera, playing the role of an Irish street musician or busker who meets an Eastern European street vendor, played by Marketa Urglova, another non-actor.
What's the check for Ocean?
Rave reviews and a Sundance Award turned the low-budget movie into a phenomenon, and Glen and Marketa, now a real-life couple, into stars, selling out concert halls wherever they perform. Through it all, Glen has managed to keep both his battered guitar and humble perspective intact.
You're never more than a step away from being back on the street busking, you know. And you're never more than a step away from having everything you've ever wanted.
Enter Mary Beth Dietrich, the Chicago woman who was enthralled by the movie and by Glen and his music.
He was a curly-headed Irishman and reminded me of someone that I used to be married to, my late husband.
Jack Dietrich died 4 years ago of pancreatic cancer. He was a music lover and a guitar collector. This past summer, when Mary Beth went to see Glen and Marketa perform at a Chicago concert, she was stunned to see the condition of his guitar and sent an email to the duo's MySpace page offering one of her husband's highly prized instruments as a gift.
I emailed her back and I was like, I don't really know what to say except that's an amazing offer and I thank you. And then I thought, you know, actually, I'd like to go visit her just for the gesture alone, just to go and say thank you.
That's himself. And his grandson has red curly hair.
Really?
But they cut it off.
But Mary Beth did not want him to leave without one of her deceased husband's guitars, knowing that Glen's instrument was nearing the end of its life.
What drives people to make such a gesture to a total stranger? What is it that makes someone go, you know what? I have, he has not. I don't know him. And I'm going to go and figure out a way to contact that person and give.
I don't know you.
The poster for the movie has a quote from Rolling Stone magazine in which it calls the movie Once a gift. So I think that movie was, I think it was a gift to me. It was a gift to a lot of people. Maybe, but possibly using this new guitar, Glen will be able to make more gifts for a lot of people.
And games that never.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
This is amazing. I'm totally honored.
Matt will play.
It was a very emotional, like, hour of my life. You know, it humbled me and still does.
For today, Mike Leonard, NBC News, Chicago.
And another happy note, the music from Once has been nominated for 2 Grammys. And coming up next, a woman who's quite familiar with the Grammy experience, MJB, Mary J. Blige, live in concert. But first, this is Today on NBC.